Good evening, dear students. In my last video, I discussed the behavior of electromagnetic waves through the conductors and defined the skin depth. In the current topic, now we will define characteristic impedance of a medium to electromagnetic waves, and then we will discuss further it in details for dielectrics as well as the conductors. Now see, what is the meaning of characteristic impedance? We have already defined characteristic impedance in the previous chapter in some other way. In this chapter, the characteristic impedance is defined for the electromagnetic waves by the different media. The characteristic impedance offered by a medium to the electromagnetic wave is defined as the ratio of the instantaneous electric field vector, means EY vector, to the instantaneous magnetic field vector, that is HZ vector. It is denoted by Z vector. That is, Z vector is equal to EY vector upon HZ vector. We will name this as equation A. My dear students, I will draw your attention over here that why I have taken EY and HZ instead of E vector and H vector. See, here I am already considering the plane polarized electromagnetic wave in which the wave is propagating along x-axis. Electric field is directed along y-axis and magnetic field is directed along z-axis. So for such a wave, impedance is given by equation number A. This is the impedance, characteristic impedance offered by a medium to the electromagnetic wave. Now we will derive its expression for two different kind of media. Its first part, part A, is impedance of a dielectric to the electromagnetic wave. It means how much impedance is being offered by a dielectric to the incoming electromagnetic wave when a wave passes through it. Now we already know that a dielectric medium is such a medium for which conductivity sigma is zero. So for such a medium, we already have defined the expressions for electric field as well as the magnetic field. So I'll rewrite the same equations. Ey is equal to E naught exponential of iota omega t minus kx. Hz is equal to H naught exponential of iota omega t minus kx. Here k, students, it is the 2 pi upon lambda, that is the wave vector. Alright. Now I am going to use these two equations in equation number A. So I'll simply get Zd, that is the electric characteristic impedance, sorry. It is the characteristic impedance Ey phasor upon Hz phasor. When you divide the two equations, you will automatically get E naught upon H naught. This is the meaning of the impedance offered by dielectric to the incoming electromagnetic wave. Now, we know I have already considered the plane polarized electromagnetic wave which is traveling along x-axis. So for such a wave, we have already derived this equation in this chapter. The spatial variation of electric field versus the time variation of the magnetic field, and is given by equation number 4. Now I am going to use the equations 1 and 2 in your equation 4. So using 1 and 2 in 4 for Ey and Hz, you will get this type of equation. Differentiate, you will get after differentiation this type of equation. Throughout cancel exponential term, you will get this. And from here, E naught upon H naught, you will get mu times omega upon k. But from equation number 3, what is E naught upon H naught? It is already Zd. So left hand side, I'll write Zd is equal to mu times omega upon mu. Now, but we know that the velocity of electromagnetic waves through dielectrics is given by 1 upon mu epsilon the square root. Equation number 7. Now, Zd phasor is equal to, using 7 and 6, I'll get Zd phasor is equal to mu upon root of mu epsilon. So mu upon root mu means root mu upon epsilon. This becomes equation number B. Now from here, it is a clear expression for characteristic impedance offered by a dielectric to the electromagnetic wave. Now what happens if this dielectric medium is taken as a vacuum or free space? For that, we will replace mu by mu naught, which is 4 pi tends to minus 7 Henry per meter in equation number B, and epsilon is equal to epsilon naught 8.85 tends to minus 12 Fermi per meter. So on putting the values of mu and epsilon as mu naught and epsilon naught in equation number B, I'll get Zd is equal to 377 ohms. So how it becomes ohms, I have already explained you in the starting of this chapter. So Zd comes out to be 377 ohms. So hence, air or free space, or you can say vacuum, it offers an impedance of 377 ohms to the flow of electromagnetic waves. Now let us move to the further part B of this topic. This is impedance of a conductor to the electromagnetic wave, means how much impedance a conductor offers when electromagnetic waves pass through the conductors. Now we already know that for a conducting media, conducting medium is such a medium for which sigma is non-zero, means conductivity becomes non-zero. So we know that the electric and magnetic field vectors for such a medium is given by equation number 8 and 9, EY phasor, HZ phasor. We have already derived these equations, assumed these equations as the solutions of the electromagnetic waves for conductors. So here iota is with omega, see equations 8 and 9, where gamma, what is gamma over here? It is 1 plus iota into k for a wave which is traveling along positive x-axis. How it is equal to this, I have already explained to you in my previous lecture. And k is nothing but mu sigma omega upon 2 the square root. These are equations 10 and 11. Now again, the same equation, that is the space variation of electric field versus the time variation of the magnetic field. So I'm going to use equations 8 and 9 here in equation number 12. I'll put the values, and on differentiation, I'll get this equation like this. So throughout, again, cancel the exponential term. You will get this type of equation, and from here I'll get E naught upon H naught is equal to mu iota omega divided by gamma as equation number 13. Now using again 13 and 3, I'll get Zc is equal to Ey upon Hz phasor, which is equal to E naught upon H naught, which is equal to mu iota omega divided by gamma. So as this name is named as equation number 14. Now dear students, 14, in the 14th equation, I'm going to use the value of gamma from equation number 11, and here comes out then again equal to k, then value, using the value of k in, from equation number 11. So you can say that I'm going to use equation 10 and 11 in 14 here. I'll get this type of equation. I'll rewrite equation, this equation in this form, and name this as equation number 15. Now I will simplify iota upon 1 plus iota. Iota over 1 plus iota can be rationalized and then simplified in the form of 1 plus iota divided by 2, which can be separated into real and imaginary parts as in equation number 16. So using the value of equation number 16 in equation number 15, I will simply get 1 by 2 plus iota into 1 by 2 square root of 2 mu omega upon sigma is equal to Zc. Now see, this root 2 can be taken here inside. So root 2 upon 2, it becomes 1 upon root 2. Similarly, this root 2 is taken over here. I'll get root 2 upon 1 by 2, means 1 upon root 2. This term would be simplified in this form as equation number 17. Now here students, this term would be again simplified in the sine or cos terms. So I can write this bracketed quantity, complex number, as 1 upon root 2 means cos pi by 4 plus iota. 1 upon root 2 means again sine pi by 4. Cos theta plus iota sine theta, it becomes exponential of iota theta, means iota pi by 4. So equation 18, I will give this name to this equation. Now using equation 18 in equation number 17, you will come out with equation number C. So Zc, it is the characteristic impedance, or you can say impedance offered by the conductors to the electromagnetic waves when they pass through the conductors. Its name is characteristic impedance, you know. Characteristic means it is the characteristic, it is the specialty of that medium for which wave is passing. If it is passing through conductors, it becomes characteristic of the conductors, means characteristic impedance offered by the conductors. And if the medium is dielectric, it becomes Zd. That means the characteristic impedance of the dielectrics offered to the electromagnetic waves. Now equation C is showing you that the characteristic impedance offered by a conductor to electromagnetic wave is a complex quantity. See, you can see over here, it's a complex quantity. with the magnitude of this one and a phase angle of pi by 4 radians or 45 degrees. Now here on the left hand side I can simplify to Ey upon Hz phasor is equal to Zc phasor, or you can say Ey is equal to Zc times of Hz, or simply removing the phasor notation you will write this equation as this one. So this equation shows that the magnetic field vector means Hz lags behind Ey by an angle of pi by 4 radians or 45 degrees. Or in other words, you can say electric and magnetic fields do not go hand in hand in electromagnetic waves when they pass through the conductors. So their equations get modified. So equations of Ey and Hz, they're just modified in the form of, if I will write equation for Ey in the form of equation number 19, so I will simply write Hz in the form of H0 exponential of iota omega t minus gamma x minus iota phi, where what is phi here? Phi is nothing but pi by 4. That means gamma and k, they are given by the same equations 10 and 11 respectively. Now phi here simply means equal to pi by 4. That means my magnetic field is, so see this negative sign. Magnetic field is not the same as that of the electric field. It is lagging behind the electric field by an angle of phi or equal to pi by 4. That's all. Thank you so much.